KDOQ ICPG 2012 update answers all these questions. So in the KDOQ ICPG, there's a recommendation that tighter glycemic control can result in severe hypoglycemic episodes. However, we have to keep the HbA1c around 7, which is the more reliable and more appropriate. But whenever HbA1c value is above 8.5, we have to recommend the vigilant attempts to tighten the glycemic control. And we recommend the intense self-monitoring to avoid the hypoglycemia in patients with high risk for hypoglycemia. And A1C is still as a routine reference to assess the long-term glycemic control in patients with CKD stage 3B or higher. But we have to keep in mind that their factors can interfere with the A1C interpretation. So how can we choose the oral hypoglycemic agent safely in the diabetes kidney disease? So there are two questions regarding with the previous EBRF guideline. Is any oral drug superior to another in terms of mortality, complication, glycemic control in patients with diabetes type 2 and CKD stage 3B or higher? Or in patients with diabetes type 2 and CKD stage 3B or higher, either maximal oral therapy or is better than starting or adding insulin at the early stage? So the question is, tomorrow, insulin or sososamla, maximum oral therapy over PMLA, which one is better in OHA? Beha CKD stage 3B and above with diabetes, ma beha pobiro, save the less rao tomorrow, swinwebame. So, fluctuation of the blood glucose and monitoring of the glycemic control and CKD, ma, we have to consider those facts. When the patient, diabetes patient, had CKD, because of the poor food intake, insufficient exercise, uremia-induced anorexia, and also because of the insulin resistant, insulin metabolism disorder, patients are at risk of both hyperglycemia and hypoglycemia. So what about usage of metformin in diabetic kidney disease? So according to the KDOQI guideline, metformin can be used in a dose adapted to the renal function as a first-line agent when lifestyle measures alone are insufficient to get A1C in design range. But we recommend the patient to stop temporarily for metformin in case of dehydration for those who undergoing contrast investigation or those who had increased risk of AKI in case of the urinary tract infection and usage of antibiotics. So nice guideline about your solution. In treatment of type 2 diabetes, metformin can be safely used up to GFR 30 ml per minute. But in the GFR 45 ml per minute, those who serve your show a nice guideline, UK guideline are pure. What about a USAR to a creatinine clearance? Metformin is contraindicated for men so in serum creatinine more than 1.5 milligram per deciliter, female so in more than 1.4 milligram per deciliter. 2012 KDOQI guideline, metformin go EGFR less than 30 ma avoid lower me because increased risk of lactic acidosis, but more than 45 ma so in not only yare so do a pure wire. This study shows that dose finding study for the use of metformin in patients with type 2 diabetes and chronic kidney disease stage 3A, 3B or 4. That 2018 March diabetes care ma pya thare kega ba. A dose finding study ma tu a dose daily dose schedule stage 3A ma 1500, 3B ma 1000. And stage 4 ma 500 milligram metformin on thong bi ya kha ma 4 months after regime ma pyan chi ya kha ma metformin concentration ni ya so yin accepted range te po bi ma mya bu lactate hyperlactatemia le absent phit bi raw A1C levels ka le did not change lo byo ba de da jaw ma lo there are no significant difference in the pharmacokinetic parameters among the CKD stage group. So the The point from this study is the metformin can be used in the safe dose of the between 500 to 1,500 milligram from the CKD stage 3 and 4. I ma tong lo ya ye so bro tu a pyo tha bai. Aro finalize lo lai de ka ma use of metformin in CKD o ji ya ka ma eGFR more than 60 so no contraindication ba. But however, we have to check the renal function annually. 45 to 60, ma so yin CKD stage 3A ma so yin no metformin go 1.5 gram te ma po thin mu lo pyo bare. Di niya yauk lo shin no jamaru a CKD go renal function go every 3 to 6 months ma set lo ame. 30 to 45 CKD 3B ma so yin no dose go 1 to 1.5. Guna study ya ro 1 gram ti be tu a pay thar CKD stage 3B ma. CKD stage 4 and 5 ma ro tu a stop metformin so pyo pyo re. Aro according to the CKD stage ne jamaru a metformin go jamaru use lo lo ya bare so ra di a pyo bare. So what about sulfonylurea? Sulfonylureas are the drugs which stimulate the endogenous insulin secretion by pancreatic beta cell, and these drugs can potentially cause hypoglycemia, especially using in the high dose or reduction of the carbohydrate intake, alcohol abuse, hepatic dysfunction, heart failure, malnutrition, advanced age. And there are some drugs which can cause displace the sulfonylurea from their binding sites and cause the interaction with the other medication. Dimara drug ba pyo le so KDOQI guideline ba pyo le so first generation of the sulfonylurea are mostly renal excreted phit de drug contraindicated lo pyo ba. Aro first generation so ba le so glibenclamide to gliburide to DRI are metabolized in the liver and excreted in the urine or equally excrete lo do hypoglycemia long lasting le phit de da jaw mlo jamaru di first generation sulfonylurea should be omitted and contraindicated. Second generation sulfonylurea are partly metabolized by the liver, so maybe use cautiously lo pyo re. Aw ai ma glimepiride ko chi me so glimepiride ka liver ma metabolized into the two metabolites. One active metabolite ka ro tu hypoglycemia o phit se de, especially renal failure so la de ka ma po pyi ro phit se de. Da jaw mlo glimepiride ko thong yin 1 mg CKD stage ma jamaru wa low dose 1 mg long ne be sa pyo glimepiride ko thong thin ne so pyo pyo de. However, glycoside ka ro metabolized by the liver to the inactive metabolites but eliminated in the urine phit de. Da jaw mlo glycoside ka ro less hypoglycemia than the other sulfonylurea so pyo thoro pyo ba. Third generation phit de ka ro glipizide ka ro best options for monitoring for the hypoglycemia. Through a short acting phit de no dose adjustment ma lo bu and moderate renal disease ma le thong nai ne so bro pyo de da ba mai use lo lo shin le glipizide ko le 2.5 to 5 mg go sa pi lo thong a me can increase the dose to the 10 to 15 mg lauk thi be jama ro pe ya me so bro pyo de aro the final sulfonylurea ne message ka ro ba da le so yin glycoside ko eGFR less than 30 ma reduce dose lo me less than 15 CKD stage 5 ma ro ma thong lo mi ya u glimepiride ko ro jama ro wa sa thong me so yin 1 mg per day ne thong me eGFR 60 au ya yin no glimepiride ko thoro avoid use lo pyo tha ba de.
CFAM, caring for well-being.